All right, we've made it through my book. I don't want to take too much longer. Thank you.
I have something I want to add before you leave. And this is, we've got through the law part of it. On making your motions, I need, for my benefit in doing the meeting, for you to be more clear and a little bit more precise. And not, because sometimes I get a second, and it's not always clear who's made that second because it's a second. And I need either second or, sometimes I get 3 seconds.
Well, and I've had some requests, if we could just make like a little, a cheat sheet that would kind of give a idea on what a recommendation. Because it's like, I've been doing it for a long time, and I was told when I first came on the board that kind of the way to do it would be, I move to make a recommendation on zoning application XXX to recommend, to send a recommendation to the Board of County Commissioners. That we're not making a decision, that we're making a recommendation with the conditions as shown by staff, if you're doing by staff, and also with the following conditions, which now we're having those shown on the board too. We don't have to read those out unless we, because in the past I have had conditions that are, 10 pages long. So, but I kind of, my criteria has always been that you move to send the recommendation to the Board of County Commissioner with a recommendation of approval or denial. So that's
okay.
Not a decision.
No, I'm okay with you all making a motion to make a recommendation. That's spelled out.
And I think we have some new board members, and they kind of got caught in the last couple months up there doing recommendations, and we haven't even talked about recommendations in here, the proper way to do it.
Okay. Yeah.
One more thing before we get shitty is, what are your thoughts, or yours and Tom's thoughts of what your contact with this board going through for the next few months or the year, or is this going to be a one-shot deal for you to come in and speak to us, or are you going to be at a couple of our meetings, or?
It's up to you all. I mean, I don't want to force myself upon you all, but Tom and I had spoken briefly about perhaps me coming to the next couple of months of meetings and just being there and just listening and offering assistance to Teresa or Tom as they need it, and maybe some pointers. And then if we decide, I don't believe anything I'm hearing necessitates the need for a permanent lawyer to be there every time for the next few years.
How about these meetings? Are you talking about just the public meeting, or are you talking about the work session and the meetings?
I'm going to play it by ear with Tom's assistance. I'm probably going to come to these work sessions a couple of times,
okay,
and the regular meetings a couple of times, and then I will probably just sort of y'all will be shed of me after a while.
Okay.
But I just want to come and just help. And I, you know, look, it's clear to me that you all are doing everything you all can do to conduct the people's business the best you can do. And all I'm here to do is to help you do that. And eventually, I will fade away, and you won't see me anymore. But I thought I might try and help a little bit.
I have one more question, too. Are we under the same rules and regulations when we are meeting as a steering committee? Because we are a quorum. We're all here.
Tell me about the steering.
And that's tomorrow night.
Is that the one Vanessa's dealing with?
Yes.
I think we've been complying with. We're doing open meetings, are we not?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we are under the same rules and regulations.
You know, Vanessa cross-examined me thoroughly about that. I almost wanted counsel to represent me. I think complying with the act is better. She agreed.
Can we get a template kind of standard language for proper motions?
Sure. Absolutely. Absolutely.
I just request you speak clearly and not all three at one time. Because it's hard to do meetings.
We run into that a lot as we're writing down who made the initial motion, and then we hear just a quick verbal second before we even look up and miss it. So.
And
part of it is too, when we miss one, we might just get on the microphone and ask you to clarify who made what, and we'll do that. as well.
Thank you, Ken.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
May I ask a question on the open records for emails? If the email is on a private personal email account and not on the county account, is it subject to Open Records Act if it has to do with the county's business?
Yes.
And even if the official is a member of the steering committee and not a member of the planning commission, they are also subject to Open Records Act because they are conducting the business of the county as a committee or agency of Forsyth County?
It would depend. I mean, I have taken the position that the steering committee is subject, is going to comply with the Open Meetings Act. I have not decided whether or not they are a true agency of the government. So I'm doing that out of an abundance of caution. I'm not sure whether I'm willing to take the next step and say that a member on that committee that I haven't even decided if they're a fit. I would have to see, I'd have to talk to that member and see what they're doing. Maybe. I mean, again, the rule is that if you are part of the agency, is the steering committee, was that created by the board committee?
The membership was identified by the board. Was it formally someone from the school board? There would be someone from the Chamber of Commerce. There would be five members of the planning
board. Okay, well, I would probably err toward making that information available.
Thank you.
Everybody understand the question, though?
On that.
Go ahead.
On the personal email account, or subject to open records, is only pertaining to county business?
It's a great question. Because obviously on anybody's, I just use this, the Bell South account, not a county account paid for by you. Yeah, not every email, just because you happen to have one or two emails that involve county business, does not make your private email account subject to the Open Records Act. It's only emails that pertain to the scope, course, and operation of county government will be subject to the act, even if they're on a private email account.
And who decides that? Is somebody going to come in and look at, is the government going to come in and look at all your emails, including all your emails to your girlfriend and all that, and then they're going to ferret out which ones that they're going to decide are the government, or is the person who owns the email account going to decide which ones they're going to turn over?
The reality is that in a private email, I have to take the word of the individual that is the subject of the request, because I don't have the authority to go into their home and pull up their emails. So what I will do, and I'm just telling you, this is what I do, yeah. I'll just ask them, do you have any emails on your private account that are responsive to this request? If you do, provide them to me. And if they say I don't, right now, as imperfect as that is, that's the answer.
Because years ago, before we had our county emails, there was an incident, and I don't remember what it was way back. It was with some employee of staff that we were asked, anything that you had, which at that time, we only had our personal accounts.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I remember going through and sending five copied back to Ken Gerard's office, and that's what everybody did.
Yeah, so the government's not looking at all your email. Yeah.
But now we have our own county one, yeah. So it's pretty easy to
separate.
Yeah, as long as you use that.
Yeah, unless y'all have any more questions for me, it's been a pleasure. Thank you all for what you do. I know it's hard.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
We really appreciate it.